subscribe to get smart, and to watch the latest videos first, hit the bell icon and you will be notified about the new videos updates instantly.
Chess is hard. True grandmasters spend years learning the underlying theory, working through puzzles, and studying their opponents in order to perfect their game. But we are going to show you how to win a match in just 3 moves. Since chess is a two-person game, this will only work if your opponent makes 2 really bad moves. You know the 2-move checkmate, or fool's mate, and you know the 4-move checkmate, or scholar's mate, but do you know the 3-move checkmate? Grab a friend, play white, and your next game of chess will take longer to set up than to play. You can achieve checkmate in 3 moves with capturing, or without capturing. For either of these methods to work, requires some pretty bad play from your opponent, but maybe you can catch her cold at the start. Hi guys, Rick here, helping you to master your chess techniques. This video is about how to win a chess match in just 3 moves. Are you ready? Stay focused. This requires total concentration. Method 1. Getting checkmate in 3 moves while capturing. In both of these methods, the key piece for you is your queen. The queen is the piece that you are going to use to achieve the checkmate. So your first move should be to open up space for the queen to move diagonally. Moving the king pawn forward 2 spaces to square e4 achieves this. As well as freeing your queen, you need your opponent to expose their king. If black then moves their bishop pawn 2 spaces to f5 to tempt white, the checkmate in 3 moves is on. Now use your pawn to capture your opponent's advanced pawn by attacking on the diagonal. Notated that c4 xf5. Here you are trying to encourage your opponent to move their knight pawn forward 2 spaces to g5, so it is alongside your pawn. This isn't a smart move from your opponent, but maybe you can lull her into it. The idea of this move is to make sure nothing can block off your route to your opponent's king. After you make your next move, checkmate. Now you can move your queen on the diagonal to h5, and you have your opponent's king pinned. That's game over. You'll notice that if your opponent hadn't moved their pawn forward 2 in their last turn, they could have blocked off your queen by putting a pawn in her way by g6. You really need your opponent to play into your hands to pull off this 3-move checkmate. Now you can take the king with your queen on the diagonal and celebrate a very swift victory. If your opponent has fallen into the trap, they will likely be a bit annoyed, so don't gloat too much. Method 2. Getting checkmate in 3 moves without capturing. This is a very similar method to the previous one. You are basically aiming to get your opponent's bishop and knight pawns forward 1 and 2 squares respectively, while freeing your queen to enable it to move onto h5. The end result is the same as the previous method. You are trying to tempt your opponent to move her bishop and knight pawns. You need your opponent to respond by bringing out her bishop pawn 1 square to f6. It can also work if she moves her knight pawn forward 2 squares, as long as she moves the bishop pawn on her next move. The next move for you to make has to free up your queen so it can get into a checkmate position on the next move. To do this, move the white king pawn ahead 2 squares to e4. Now you have opened up an avenue for your queen to reach h5. In order to clear the way to your opponent's king, you need her to move her knight pawn ahead 2 spaces to g5. Checkmate. And that's it. You have trapped your opponent's king in the same position as the previous method, but this time you did it without even capturing a single piece. Match over. Again. This looks simple and it is. So don't expect it to work very often. In theory, there are loads of variations on this. The key moves are getting your queen to h5 and your opponent's bishop and knight pawns out of the way of her king. Before I end this video, if you want something specific to show in my next video, just say in the comment section below. If you found this video entertaining and enjoyable, give me a favor by clicking that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'll catch you all in the next episode of Get Smart. Peace.